Hello everyone, welcome back to the Selenium 2018 tutorial using C# and Microsoft Visual Studio 2017. In the last video, we saw page object model and page object model page factory using page object model. So these are the two important things. But as we know, to know that a test case is passed or failed, we need to have some reports. So reporting is a very important mechanism, a very important thing in testing. So if you are coming from Java and Eclipse, you would have seen there are two mechanisms by which you can see report. One is a default report that is generated by TestNG, and second is the XSLT report, which gets generated using the pom.xml. So in C#, you can also have some mechanism, a third party tool called extend reports. It works very perfectly and very cleanly with Java and Eclipse. That can also be used in Visual Studio using C#. So today we're going to learn how to use, how to install extend reports, how to use extend reports. So I'll show you how it looks. So the advantage is it looks very fantastic. It looks very clean. It has a dashboard. You can see test cases part this and how much time it took, what are the steps, what failed, what passed, and it shows very interactive graphs, pie charts, etc. And you can also click on this and they have two different themes. Now we're going to see how to install this and how do we make extend reports. To do that, of course, we have to go to the NuGet manager. If you're not familiar, right click on project and manage NuGet pack. So this is what you get. What we have to do is we have to write extend. So we will see extend reports. So extend reports, in browse section. So extend reports is this by event stack. So If you will search on internet, there are many and many reports that have used extend reports using 2.40, 2.40.2 and 2.41 versions. So these are obsolete versions. This, they might still work, but they have now a different mechanism of how to create a report. So we will be using the latest available, that is 3.1.3, and it is published on April 3rd. So let us click on install. When you click on install, you will see there are many other packages that will get installed, like JSON Razor and interop time and etc. So this will take at some time, so don't panic like it's not installing and it is not coming in package.config. So we'll see in a moment that it will show a list like Agility, Razor and all. Let's hope it comes quickly. Yep, so you can see it is installing Mongo, db.json, and this one, and this one. So let us click on I accept. So you can see it is installing sister interop services, agility, and all. So let us wait to get it installed. Just wait, so we can see successfully installed, like it says finished. So now you have extend reports installed on your system. So what we're going to do is you can see their extend config.xml is already here. So when you install it, it gets here. And you can see in packages.config, now it has extend reports and all the other packages that get installed using this. So now the thing is, how do we use it? So as we have installed it, now how do we use this extend report. We're going to this is our solution, so right click and add a new class. So let us name some element like extend report demo. Let us add, let us make it public. So this is our test case or test class. So we should mention here that this is test class. Okay, we need to have using so now we have this annotation of test class. So now we need to have a test method. So public, let us make as, let us give it a decent name like extent method, or even better, extent test case. So to know the unit testing that it is a test method, let us put annotation of test method. So now compiler knows that this is a test method and it will run as a test method. So now we need to have the event stack or the extend reports namespace. So we can use using event stack dot extend reports, and second one is using event stack dot extend reports dot reporter. So these are the two namespaces which will we need, and we'll need some more as per our use. So we will look that in some time. So for now we need to have an HTML reporter. So we'll create a variable of HTML reporter. It will be of type new extent HTML reporter. So whatever you will give a name here, a file of this name will get generated in the debug folder. I am only giving the name. So what it will generate the report in the debug folder. If you want to have that report in a specific path, use dot double slash and give your path, or use the @ and give the path later. So now we have this is the HTML which will get displayed. So now we have the extent the HTML reporter. Now we need to have a object of extent report. So we'll create an variable of extent report. Let us name it extent new, and we'll use extent reports. So now we have an object of extent reports. Now we need to have this extent dot attach reporter. Now we'll give the HTML reporter name. So we have that HTML reporter as we have defined it earlier. So now we are ready for the test case or the extent report, which will add the further variables to it. So one way of doing it is, let us say we are hard coding it, which is not a good way, but for now we'll change later. So we can use extend dot add system info. So what add system info use it on a report itself, it will show whatever we put on here, like what is the operating system, what is the host name, what is the browser, and all these elements whichever is required or you feel necessary. So it takes two values, string name and string value. So whatever you put here will get reflected. So let us copy it. So what we can show first, like what operating system this test run. So like we have Windows 10. If you want to mention the version also, like which version, I'm using 1803. You can write whatever you mention. And what we can add is here, like what is our host name, so we can know that at which PC it ran. And here we can name my PC, so let us name it PC, as my PC name is different, so we get affected later, like if we change. And also we can write here what browser we are using, because we need to have which browser was used to run this test case. So we can write browser comma, like we'll be using Chrome. So I'm writing Chrome, but to be more specific, Google Chrome. You can edit or chop any of this thing. It will not be a bigger deal like here. So now we have this variables or environment. Now we need to start our test. So we'll make a variable of the test, which what we do, extend dot, and it will start a test case. So extend dot create test, and you can name whatever test case you want to mention. So we'll be using this one, the method name, so we can know that this method was used, and it will get reflected there, you will see in a moment. So now we have our test started. So whatever you want to log here, you can put it here, like if you want to log info, if you want to log what is the status, it is either pass, fail, warning, or any other method, it will get reflected on the extent report in HTML. So for this demo purposes, we'll be using some of the steps. So let us make test.log, and let us put status dot like these are the all the debug, error, fail, fatal, info, pass, skip, warning. So these all have their different colors and respective colors, and you can filter out that in HTML report. So let us write like info, and let us this is the value here. So we can write whatever string we want to write it. So let us put it like step one test case starts. Similarly, you can put whatever information you want. So we have not info pass, so let us use test.log status dot. So earlier was info, so let us use this pass, and again you can write whatever you want to write here. So for pass we shall write step two test is for pass. Now we can add more like test.log. So let us put the common one, that is fail, which will often look in our reports. So let us, it should be two. So there is no need to write step one, step two, three. I am writing this to make this report look good. We need to only to write this step one, step two. So let us write test case fail. And what we do in Selenium is we capture screenshot and put the screenshot here. So you can also do that here. Like you can write test or like pass fail, whatever you want to, if it pass, what screenshot you want to log, if fails, whatever. So on a series you can write it here. So like it is on test case pass. So what we can do is we can pass string or the exception. So let us pass string of like screenshot and let us put a comma here. Now it says media entity model provider, so we need to have this also. So let us try to put media entity and model provider, or we should have another one, like there it is, media entity builder. And if you put dot, you will see it says create screen capture from base64 string from path and etc. So we'll use the second one, and here we need to define path or the name of the screenshot. So let us name it screenshot.png. Here it is, screenshot.png. Now we have to build this. That is a function. You need to write a function. Now what we do here is you can adjust all of these things, like whatever you want to write here and whatever you remove, you can fine tune it later. Like if one to do that, test dot pass and like screenshot. So you can use this way also, screenshot, and wait. Dot add screenshot from path, and here we need to mention the same path in quotes. So what we have is screenshot dot png, let us put a semicolon there. And this you have to remember the last step very well, because if you're not writing it, your report will not get generated. So what you need to do is you have to write extend dot flush. If you're not writing this, most people make the same mistake. They write every step and they forget to use extend flush in the end. What we do in general practice is we put this extend dot flush is before suit or before test or in the before section, whatever annotation we are using. So when a test case is, when test suit is created, we create the extend, and while we are ending the test case or the test suit, we then extend dot flush, because this is needed to complete the extend reports. So let us create this. Let us run this one more time. So now run test is started. And finished. So as we have not mentioned the path here, the extent report.html will get generated in the default by default in the debug folder. So how you can debug folder, you can right click on the project and open folder in File Explorer. Go to the bin debug and you will see the extent report here. Double click it to open, and you can see that this interactive report is here. So we wrote test.fail, so this test case got failed here. So this is all the statuses here. You can filter it out by here or from here. Like if you click on the info, only info section will get displayed. You can clear the filter from this cross icon. So only if you want to show only the pass cases, you can write pass and only pass statuses will display clear. Similarly for failed and so on so forth, you can see it is very interactive image, and this has a very important this donut chart. Like, and in the that you can search by as many time as you can from here. Like if there are multiple test cases and you want to filter out it by a particular test case, you can search it. And so let us go back to the dashboard. One more thing, like as we have saw earlier, like it has the dark theme as well, and using the whatever accessibility or color contrast mode whichever you want to present, you can select it here. If you want to prefer the dark, you can show your report in this dark theme. So let us quickly jump onto the dashboard. You can see our environments are here, how many tests it run, how many steps it took, what is the start time, what is the end time, how much time it took. Again, this is the environment. As you remember, like we hard coded this, the operating system equal to Windows 10, host name equal to Selenium PC, and browser equal to Google Chrome. So you can use the typical C# methods to get these values automatically. So that this one generates perfectly, the hard coding is not a correct way. So like let's go back to the Visual Studio. So like we got operating system here, so now we want to use the real value. Like if we want to use find what the operating system is, we can write, we use the typical C# methods which we use, like string, let's say host name equal to DNS. So DNS is not here, so you have to use using system.net. So this namespace, you need to have this DNS. Now you can see class using system.net.dns. So DNS dot, and you should have get host name, I think. Yep, get host name. So you will get the host name from here. So instead of like writing host name like Selenium PC, you can write host name here. So host name will get, I think my PC name is Sandeep PC, so it will reflect here. And similarly, if you want to have the Windows 10, like which operating system it is working, so you can have that using operating system like OS equal to, now use environment, yes we have environment dot, it should have OS version, I think. Yep, it has OS version. So this value will get still here, so you can use this value. I think your string type, no, we have to convert it. So we can use os dot like to string, or whatever you want to use, convert dot to string for the null values, you can do it here. So similarly for browser, you can change the value and you can find it using the usual C# code. So now these values get get dynamically. So again, this is just one test method. You can create multiple test methods and run it as a one or a test two. So let us run this again and see what values do we get. I hope it runs again. Started. the soap finishes. So it got finished. Let's go back again. Click here. Open folder in Fire Explorer. Go to the bin. Debug. And here it is. Let us open this extent report. You can see it has the same values because we didn't change. Only the dashboard values we got changed. So you can see the operating system is now very detailed, like Microsoft Windows NT 10.0.174. So it is getting a detailed version of that. You can trim it using usual C# methods again. Now host name is Sandeep PC. It gets it is the actual PC name. If you have used for browser, you should have effect like Chrome 64, I think 64, 66. I don't remember exactly which browser version I'm using, so it will get reflected as Chrome 64 or Chrome version number. So you, I think I have tried to explain reports as simple as that. So if you have some question, please write down in comments. Please share this video with your friends if possible. So again, I am repeating, I am not an expert. I learn whatever I learn, I put it here. So make sure you subscribe to the channel so that whatever I put next, you get to see it as soon as possible. So thanks for this video. Please share this video, like, subscribe, usual YouTube thing. So I'll see you guys in the next one. Thank you.